It happened in the past. It was a long time ago. Why blame me for what my ancestors did? This is another ridiculous notion. They, modern-day Europeans, have inherited directly all the liabilities as well as the assets of preceding states, preceding organizations, commercial companies, and all other organizations, all other entities. It's part of law, European law, that if you inherit a state or a company, you inherit both the liabilities and the assets. And in this way, Europeans have inherited the consequences, good and bad, of their forebears. It was a minority of Europeans who owned enslaved Africans. But the vast majority of Europeans, all Europeans, have gained from the enslavement of African people, because the economy of Europe is an economy that was built upon the enslavement of African people, not only, but substantially.
I don't think people really understand that, you know, just how much they've actually gotten from slavery. They think that, okay, we had slavery, and then we had the 13th Amendment, the 14th Amendment, the 15th Amendment, we had Reconstruction, and then that was it. Things were fine. You know, you could work, you could fix shoes, you could work in the mall, you could do whatever, whatever, which isn't true, because you had Jim Crow. And then even after that, you know, things weren't better. So now, theoretically, you can work wherever you want, but, you know, first you have to go to college, and before you go to college, you have to go to a good school. But your school is not good, and why isn't it good? Because your neighborhood's segregated, which in and of itself wouldn't necessarily be a bad thing, except that schools are locally funded, and so if you're living in a neighborhood and your school is, you know, funded by property taxes and nobody owns a home there, then what good is that doing you? And so, yeah, I think I'm for them. I don't believe this nonsense about it causing a bigger rift and making matters worse and, you know, opening old wounds, because I don't think wounds have actually been healed. Maybe if this happened, you would be able to have some sort of sense of closure. Or at least the beginning of closure, the beginning of a dialogue.
So reparations is a total project. First, it involves a public discourse. We got to talk about it, because Europeans always want to deny what they did. And sometimes blacks don't even understand what happened to them. They know something happened, but they can't righteously get it together. So we need this public discourse. Then we need public admission of Holocaust, not admission of trade, all that, you know? Business gone bad with collateral damage. We need a Holocaust, a moral and monstrous act of genocide. People have to confess to that, and the government has to do it. You know why the state has to do it? The state has to do it because the state sanctioned it and protected it with law and gun.
Why not an apology? Well, it would be simple, wouldn't it? Slavery was wrong, it was abominable, we're sorry, we were involved in it. Why is it so political? Because of the guilt of it, for one. And secondly, the fear of reparations. If there is an apology, then there is an admission of wrong. And I think the fear then is it would open the nations up, both Britain and the US, to lawsuits and to reparations. So both are the same. Blair, Bush, Clinton before him, will stop short of an apology, will not apologize for slavery. They won't do it. I think Blair is on record saying it was legal at the time. So nothing, no apology in order. There's no need. It was legal. Wow, that's interesting. But the Holocaust was legal according to Hitler. You know, but it's very wrong.